Hi, good morning, students. Now, in this class, I am going to discuss some problems based on vertically projected body. Right? Up to freely falling body, we'll do all the things in previous videos and also previous ideas. So, next one, for vertically projected body, there is an example one here. See clearly. Suppose if a body projected vertically upwards, with a velocity u, a body projected vertically upwards with a velocity u, so that the distance traveled in the last second of its upward journey or upward motion is d. Okay, na? So a body projected vertically upwards with a velocity u, so that the distance traveled by the body in the last second of its upward motion is d. Is like that. If the velocity of projection is doubled, find the distance traveled in the last second of its upward motion is dash. So the options given as 4D, 3D, D, 2D and fourth one D. These are the options. Come on, see here. A body projected vertically upwards with a velocity u, so that the distance traveled in the last second of its upward motion is d. Okay? Now, if the velocity of projection is doubled, find the distance traveled by the body in the same last second of its upward motion. So, that is the situation. Already, when you check, suppose it is a vertically projected body, Now, in this upward motion, the distance traveled in the last second is equal to, say, this SCR. Total time taken to reach the maximum height is equal to n seconds, and put n second in the last second. So, this is SN, okay? This should be equal to, it is the distance traveled by a freely falling body in the first second. Okay, na? I already discussed this. So, the distance traveled by a vertically projected body in the last second is equal to distance traveled by a freely falling body in the first second. It is also equal to, in case of freely falling body, what is the formula? G by 2 into 2n minus 1. That is, G by 2 into 2 into n is 1. And then 2 minus 1 is equal to G by 2. G by 2 means 9.8 by 2. 9.8 by 2 means it is equal to 4.9 meters. Okay? Remember, my dear students, the distance traveled in the last second should be equal to distance traveled by a freely falling body in the first second, you know. But this distance traveled by the freely falling body is independent of this velocity. The velocity is dependent on whatever may be the velocity of projection. The distance traveled in the last second should be equal to distance traveled by the freely falling body in the first second, which remains constant. So here, the distance traveled in the last second is equal to d. If the velocity is double, find the distance traveled means which one is the correct option? Fourth option. But which one effect here? It effect out on the end day, maximum height effect out on, because maximum height reached by a vertically projected body is equal to u square by 2. See? Here, 2 and g constant in the same place. Now, h is directly proportional to u square, so that h1 by h2 is equal to u1 by u2 whole square, u1 is equal to u by u2 is equal to 2u whole square, given u cap, this is equal to 1 by 4. Kabati, the maximum height triangle should be equal to 4 times of the maximum height in the first place. Okay? Maximum height change of the kani, distance traveled in the last second should not change, even if the velocity of projection is doubled or tripled or 4 times increased to 4 times. Okay? Some important point. So, the next example is, see one more example. Okay. It is given by this problem. A body thrown up vertically upwards, thrown vertically upwards with an initial velocity u, u reaches the maximum height in 6 seconds. The ratio of the distance traveled by the body in the first second to be seventh second is dash. Now the options are 1 is 1, 11 is 1, 1 is 2, 4th one, 1 is 2. This is the problem. Okay? A body thrown up with an initial velocity u so that it reaches the maximum height in what time? 6 seconds. Find the ratio of the distance traveled by the body in the first second to the 7th second. In the first second to the 7th second. Solution. Very, very easy and also logical. Suppose it is projected vertically upwards from the ground with a velocity u. It reaches the maximum height in what time? Maximum height is given as 20 times 11 hours. Time of this. It is given as 6 seconds. Okay? So then what is the formula for time of this? You know, TA is equal to u by z. U by z is equal to 6 and u is equal to 6g. How is it? Initial velocity in terms of 0, 6. What do you mean? Find the ratio of the distance traveled by a body in the first second to the 7th second. In the first second, anupumana. In the first second is equal to S1 for vertically connected body. Maximum height to reach the body in 6 seconds. 7 seconds means after it will interval, the body will be returned. Just like as a free falling body, you know. Come in. For this body, 7 seconds means it is a distance traveled by a freely falling body in the first second. Okay, na? Right. So here, this distance traveled is equal to S2. So the required ratio in what is S1 by S2. It is come. S1 is the distance traveled by a vertically projected body in the first second. What is the formula? U minus g by 2 into 2 minus 1. 2n minus 1 is equal to 1 plus 2 minus 1. It is also equal to g by 2 by s2 is equal. For a freely falling body, distance traveled in the first second is equal to g by 2. Already discussed in this concept. Yes, sir. Distance traveled by a freely falling body in the first second is given by g by 2, which is 9.2. So this is equivalent to S1 is equal to, here what is it? U is replaced by 6G. 6G minus G by 2 by G by, that is equal to LCM meaning 2 LCM. And 12G minus G by G by, 12G minus G is equal to 11G by 2 into n total 2 by G. Reverse. 2 cancel, GG cancel. So the what answer? 11 is 1. So the second answer is the right answer. But the way right. Next one. One more example. See one more example.
Start.
Right, see here. One more example. A body is thrown vertically upwards. A body projected vertically upwards. To reach its maximum height in 10 seconds. To reach its maximum height in T seconds. In T seconds. Okay? The total time from the time of projection point of projection total time from the point of projection to reach a point at half its maximum height while returning is options are, this is asked once in May 2008. The option is root 2 into t. Second option 1 plus 1 by root 2 into t. Third one 3t by 2 and fourth one T by U. This is the question. See, my dear students, a body projected vertically upwards to reach its maximum height in what time? T seconds. See the solution clearly. A body projected vertically upwards with a velocity U, it reaches a maximum height and maximum height verified by the vertically projected body is equal to h. Time taken by the body to reach the maximum height is given by time of ascent. It is given by t. It is enough. Find the total time from the point of projection to reach a point at half its maximum height while returning journey. So, after reaching the maximum height, the body once again retraces its path. Like in the question. And this is the half the maximum point. It is here now. Let us find the total time taken by the body to reach the point C in the second journey. So, C is a point at half the maximum point. C is the point at half the maximum point. Okay? But if I don't share it, half the maximum height can I be? And this distance should be equal to h by 2 and this is a freely falling body. You know, for freely falling body, v velocity is equal to 0. Right? What is the given answer is, given solution is, time of ascent Ti is equal to u by c and this should be equal to t. Is it allow this? For a freely falling body, you know, from v to c, in case of freely falling body, the time taken to reach from B to C is given by, we have a value of
yes, displacement there is initial velocity zero. We are determining the time. That means from S is equal to unit of half x square for real freely finding word e becomes zero. But S is equal to half g p dash square. S is equal to h by 2, you know, h by 2 is equal to half g into t dash square. 2 cancel. Again, h is replaced by what the formula? U square by 2g is equal to g into t dash square. G could have only t dash square is equal to u square by 2g square. Or t dash is equal to u by root 2 into g. But you know, u by g is equal to what the formula? U by g is equal to t dash. But this is equal to t by root 2. This is t by 2. Okay? Time taken by the body to reach from B to C is equal to t by root 2. From A to maximum height is equal to t. Therefore, the total time taken by the body to reach from A to B and again from B to C is given by t plus t dash. That is, t plus t dash is given by t by root 2 is equal to t common this way. 1 plus 1 by 2 into t. This is the right answer. Which is the correct option? Second. Right? Okay. Next one. See one example. One more example. Observe. A boy throws. A boy throws n bars per second at regular time intervals. When the first bar reaches the maximum height, the second one, he throws the second one. Then the maximum height reached by each ball is options are g by 2 into n minus 1 whole square, second one g by 2n square, third one g by n square, and fourth one g by. Okay, any question? Read the question carefully. A boy throws n balls in 1 second. At regular time intervals. When the first ball reaches the maximum height, he throws the second one. Find the maximum height reached by each ball. Okay? Please, it's basic the previous one. Very easiest questions. Simply and easily, you can develop the solutions or how to solve the problems or how to solve the numericals in physics step by step. Okay? So these are the basic points. If we complete it in graph, we can do the sums connecting to the motion in straight line, means motion under gravity, with another concepts. Okay? Children, suppose a boy throws n balls per second typically, of course. N balls per second. If it is aimed at number of balls are positioned, suppose the first ball positioned only. When the first ball reaches the maximum height, he throws the second ball. This is second ball. And then, the
first ball ki patte time difference entu untundo find out cheyali kada manaku the time taken by the ball to reach the maximum range is called time of essence here you know initial velocity projection is equal to u given unnam anukondi so ichindi in 1 second he throws how many balls 10 balls okay na oka second lo 10 balls throw chesina ante time for n balls is equal to entandi 1 second time for n balls is equal to 1 second what is the time for 1 ball 1 ball throwing time is equal to entha avutundi 1 by n ayi raavali 1 by n seconds okay and the time interval between these two bodies to be equal to time of essence the time of essence is also equal to time taken by the ball to reach a maximum height which is equal to 1 by n okay then this time taken by the ball to reach the maximum height is called time of essence this time of essence is equal to u by z so u by z is equal to entha avutundi 1 by n or u is equal to z by n v equal to z by n Then how do you find the maximum height reached by each ball? Maximum height reached is equal to 4 u square by 2 z. Again here u is replaced by g by n, and then g square by n square by 2 z. Here g g cancel, so that should be equal to g by 2 n square. This formula for maximum height reached by each ball. So the correct option is second. Okay.